17 secrets to enjoy supernatural speed at the finger of God in royal choice in 2017. Beloved, if you are part of this commission and you want to enjoy supernatural speed at the finger of God, as our team is, you must get yourself involved in this. Job 22 verse 28. Thou will also decree a thing, and it will be established unto you, and the light shall shine upon thy ways. 28:22. Destruction and death say, we have heard the fame thereof with our ears. May the Lord bless the reading of his word. May the Lord bless the reading of his word. And everybody say a loud amen. Amen. 17 secrets that will lead you and allow you to enjoy supernatural speed and the finger of God. Do you really want to enjoy it? I'm giving you 17 secrets. What God gave to me. God said, my son, take paper, take Bible. I want to speak to you concerning how your people will enjoy supernatural speed, so that it will not just be a team and they will miss it, but they will enjoy it. Number one, live for Jesus in the secret and open in 2017. Don't claim to be right. Still number one, when you discover something wrong, don't be ashamed to confess Jesus anywhere you are. Live for him. The temptations may be much, but you will never allow the temptation as more than you to get you. Number two, live a life of covenant in 2017. Beloved, there are so many things you can never overcome until you live a life of covenant. There are so many things you can never overcome until you live a life of covenant. The life of covenant is what makes the difference between who goes up and who comes down. Psalm 74 verse 20. Have respect unto the covenant, for the dark places of the earth are full of the habitation of cruelty. Since man fell in the Garden of Eden, God does no longer trust man until man goes into covenant with God. It is that covenant God looks unto. He is the superior, we are the inferior. He's always faithful to his promises. Do you want to see God in a different form in 2017? Then live your life of covenant. Don't joke with covenant. Covenant is a secret. The difference between David and his brothers is that his brothers consecrated themselves for a purpose, because they were going to choose a king, and they began to make covenant for that purpose only. But David lived a life of covenant every day, even without knowing that somebody was going to be chosen from the family for anything. He was living the life. It was part of him. And when the real anointing came, the anointing could not fall on those who were waiting for a purpose. The anointing looked for the one who made the covenant to be a lifestyle. I pray for you today, covenant shall be a lifestyle in 2017. A life of covenant. If you take decisions, decisions are not enough. Decisions can fail you. You can take decisions that I will not do this again. I will not do this. I will not do this. The same day you break it. But if it's a covenant in 2017, if you live a life of covenant, you are going to celebrate. And I see you celebrate in Jesus' name. I see you celebrate. Make covenant. Sometimes your strength may fail you. All you know may fail you, but covenant can never fail you. You'll get to a point, you won't know what to do again. Everything that holds you will fail you, but covenant will keep you. Because covenant that is real is a covenant that has A and B. It has side A and side B. Side A, if I do this, let these curses come upon me, terrible curses. But if I don't do them, let these blessings be my portion. Those things are trust God's hand very quickly. I pray for you, in that name that is above all names, as you made this covenant, you will celebrate today. Starting from today, you never go down. Number three, make soul winning, evangelism, and invitation to church activities and programs a major part of your program in 2017. Win souls, evangelize. If you cannot, invite people. Make this a major part of your program. As you are planning how to go up, make this a major part of your program in 2017. Win souls, evangelize in your office, your business centers, your school, anyone that comes across you in your house, tell them about Jesus. If you cannot, invite them to church program. It's part of it. This is 2017, and there are 17 secrets I'm giving you. And as you obey these 17 secrets, you will testify. Number four, Don't kill yourself because of destructive criticism of men against you. Don't kill yourself because of destructive criticism of men anywhere against you. Do you want to grow? Do you want to get to the next level? Destructive criticism will help you. I'm not talking about constructive criticism. I'm not talking about the criticism one is criticizing to help you. That one is different. But destructive one will catapult you this year. They say, let's do it to bring him down. As they try to bring you down, they will go down, you will go up. If you read a shout out, amen loud. Matthew chapter 5. Don't bother yourself because it's what will lift you. Matthew chapter 5, verses 11 and 12. Blessed are ye when men shall revere you and persecute you and shall say all manner of evil against you falsely for my sake. Rejoice and be exceedingly glad, for great is your reward in heaven. For so persecuted they the prophets which were before you. So don't bother about that. That's one of the greatest ways and fastest ways you grow. Number 5, pray for opportunities to invest your best in God's kingdom. And always involve yourself in kingdom sacrifices. And above all, pray to fulfill it in order to attract speedy result. Amen. Amen. Number 6, do not be a partaker of other men's sins. Keep yourself pure by intelligently avoiding such group. People will say some things or do some things and attract the wrath of God. And they will come and indirectly bring you in to be a part of it. And one thing you will do or act or say will make you a partaker of what will come. Do not be a partaker of other men's sins in 2017. Once you discover that I'm not supposed to be in this group, intelligently avoid such group. And you see God take you to the next level. You see God take you to the next level. 1 Timothy chapter 5, verse 22. Lay hands suddenly on no man. Neither be partaker of other men's sins. Keep yourself pure. Keep yourself pure. These are secrets that will take us to the next level. Oh my God, I must enjoy supernatural speed. I must experience the finger of God. But these are the secrets. Number 7, commitment to Sunday services and weekly activities. You can't sleep at home on Sunday. Go to Psalm 122 verse 1. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. That was David. I was glad whenever it was Sunday. I was glad whenever it was activity day, midweek service. I was glad. I was glad whenever they said, let's go into the house of God. No wonder he was distinguished from the crowd. So commitment to Sunday services and weekly activities. You can't sleep at home in 2017. Number 8, very important. Tell a neighbor, very important. Tell a neighbor, number 8 is very important. When God gave it to me, I put asterisk. Number 8, delete some contacts in your phone today. Tell your neighbor, if the person didn't hear very well, delete some contacts. Talk to somebody, say, delete some contacts in your phone today. And say goodbye to some people in some associations today. Delete some contacts that never helped you. Delete some contacts that nearly destroyed their life. Right in the church here, bring out your phone and delete. Some people ran to me when we traveled and said, please, show us the ones we delete. I said, you are the one to tell me the ones that destroyed you. I begin to delete them. Delete some contacts you know that will destroy you again. Those contacts, don't do out of sympathy. Delete them. There are some people that may want to run away from you this year. Hold them. They will add to your life. If you see them run, hold them. Tell them, please don't leave me. I'm not talking about those that will destroy you. The ones that will destroy, delete in the church now. Delete some contact. You know them. Take your phone, even as I'm preaching, and delete. What I'm saying is very simple. Do you want to enjoy supernatural speed and the finger of God? Delete some contact. Turn to your neighbor and say, did he get this one? Delete some contact. 2017, if you want to testify with me, delete some contact. There are some people, every day, they will take you to a restaurant only to destroy you. They call, let's go to a restaurant. Let's go to a party, cinema, all these ones. Nothing has been added to your life. only subtraction, subtraction, subtraction. Do you want to rule from beginning to end? Delete them. But there are some people, even at their weak point, they are blessings to you. There are some people, even at their zero level, they are blessings to you. Those are the ones that can help you. I pray for you today, your eyes will open to delete some contacts. Turn to your neighbor, say, I will delete. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, 33. Be not deceived. Evil communication corrupt good manners. Be not deceived. Evil communication corrupt good manners. Delete some contacts. Number 9. Never struggle with your 100% tithe. Faithfulness to tithe in 2017. Never struggle. Malachi 3, 8 to 10. Never struggle with your tithe in 2017. Will a man rob God? Yet you have robbed me. But you say, wherein have we robbed thee? In tithes and offering. You are cursed with a curse. Let me ask you, if God curses you, who will break it? Nobody. Now, you are cursed with a curse, for you have robbed me, even this whole nation, bringing all the tithes into the storehouse, that there may be meat in my house. And prove me now, herewith say the Lord of hosts, if I will not open you the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing, there shall not be room enough to receive it. And I will rebuke the devourer. That's the most important aspect. The devourer may come to kill you. The devourer may come to destroy you. But he said, don't worry. Your tithe will speak for you. And I will rebuke the devourer for your sake. And he shall not destroy the fruit of your ground. Neither shall your vine cast a fruit before the time in the field. Say the Lord of hosts. Which means there will be no sudden destruction. That's what it means. Look at the last verse. And all nations shall call you blessed. For you shall be a delightsome land. Say the Lord of hosts. And that's their portion this year. Number 10. Beautify the church anyhow best you can in 2017. Beautify the church. Beautify the church anyhow best you can. Anyhow you know you can beautify the church. This is one of the 17 secrets that will catapult you to supernatural speed and the finger of God in 2017. Number 11. Love, honor, defend, and pray for your pastors in 2017. Love, honor, defend, and pray for your pastors in 2017. The value you place on your pastor determines the virtue that flows from him to you. Number 12, sow upward. That's what God told me. Sow upward even more in 2017. Sow even more in the lives of those who have already for greater open doors. It does not mean you will not help the poor. You will help the poor. But God says, should tell the church, learn how to sow even to the life of those who have. If you want to enjoy greater open doors. Number 13, marry your Bible every day. Marry your Bible every day. Observe quiet time every day. Let there be no day that you will not study the Bible. Joshua 1:8. This book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night, that thou mayest observe to do according to all that is written therein. For then thou shalt make thy ways prosperous, and then thou shalt have what? Good success. Number 14, discover and practice how to pull down any long-standing evil altar speaking against you by erecting new altars by sacrifice for supernatural speed. The fastest way to challenge God is to erect altar constantly. Erect altars constantly. If you want to enjoy God, make sure you practice what I'm telling you. You see what will happen. Judges chapter 6, 25 to 32. And it came to pass the same night that the Lord said unto him, take thy father's young bullock, that's Gideon, even the second bullock of 7 years old, and throw down the altar of Baal that thy father had, and cut down the groove. First of all, pull down evil altar by sacrifice. Before you erect new altar, you pull down what? The old one. Now, and build an altar. After you have pulled down that one, build an altar unto the Lord. Two things. You pull down, you build. Build an altar unto the Lord, thy God, upon the top of this rock, in the other place. And take the second bullock and offer a burnt sacrifice with the wood of the groove, which thou shalt cut down. Look, it said, in the ordered place. There must be a place you are meant to go and erect the altar. In the ordered place. You must be ordered to do it. Yes. Then Gideon took the 10 men of his servant and did as the Lord has said unto him. And so it was, because he feared his father's household and the men of the city, that he could not do it by day, that he did it by night. And when the men of the city arose early in the morning, behold, the altar of Baal was cast down, and the groove was cut down that was by it, and the second bullock was offered upon the altar. And the second bullock, I want the church to get the secret. And the second bullock, the first bullock was used to cast down the evil altar, and the second bullock was used to erect new altar. Am I communicating? If you want result, you pull down evil altar by sacrifice. You erect another one by sacrifice. And the second bullock was offered upon the altar that was built. And they said one to another, who had done this thing? And when they inquired and asked, they said, Gideon, the son of Joash, had done this thing. Then the men of the city said unto Joash, bring out thy son that he may die, because he has cast down the altar of Baal, and because he hath cut down the groove that was by it. And Joash said unto all that stood against him, will you plead for Baal? Will you save him? He that will plead for Baal, let him be put to death. Whilst it is yet morning, if he be a god, let him plead for himself, because one has cast down his altar. Somebody say fire. If he's strong enough, somebody has used sacrifice to cast down his altar, let him plead for himself. Hear me very well. Every evil altar in your father's house, every evil altar in your mother's house, every evil altar in your in-law's place, every evil altar in your friend's place, every evil altar in your office, every evil altar in your shop, every evil altar in your business place, in your school, where you reside, that is fighting against you, that is speaking against you, by the reason of erecting altar, I pull them down. By the reason of today's service, I pull them down. They are pulled down forever in Jesus' name. You got the secret. You use sacrifice to pull down long-standing evil altar. And after that, you don't rest. You also use sacrifice to erect the new one you want. That's the secret. Number 15. Make up your mind to walk in the house of God. There must be something you work for God here. There must be something you do for God. Don't just fold your hands. Number 16. You need uncommon supernatural wisdom to excel in 2017. Human wisdom will take you nowhere. You need supernatural wisdom. This wisdom will distinguish you. This wisdom will tell you the right time, the right place, what right to do and what not to do. Receive that wisdom now. Receive it now. Receive. Receive in Jesus' mighty name. Number 17, the last one before we pray. You need 1 Kings 18:46 to be distinguished in 2017. What is in 1 Kings 18 verse 46? That is what you need. Let's stand up as we read that place. 1 Kings chapter 18 verse 46. And the hand of the Lord was on Elijah. And he gathered up his loins and ran before Ahab to the entrance of Jezreel. That is in 2017, the hand of God will be upon you. And it is called the finger of God. If you want to understand this place very well, let's read from verse 41. Let's read from verse 41. And Elijah said unto Ahab, Ahab was the president of the country, get thee up, eat, drink, for there is a sign of abundance of rain, because there was no rain in the land. Everybody was mourning because there was no rain. And Elijah got up and said, I've been praying for you, rain is coming now. He said, eat, drink, for there is a sign of abundance of rain. 42. So Ahab went up to eat and to drink, and Elijah went up to the top of Carmel, and he cast himself down upon the earth and put his face between his knees and said unto his servant, go up now, look toward the sea. And he went up and looked and said, there is nothing. And he said, go again 7 times. And it came to pass at the 7th time that he said, behold, there ariseth a little cloud out of the sea like a man's hand. And he said, go up, say unto Ahab, prepare the chariot and get thee down, that the rain stop thee not. And it came to pass in the meanwhile that the heaven was black with cloud and wind, and there was a great rain. And Ahab rode and went to where? Jezreel. He was in his horse. Today you can say his car. The car was going, and they said the first person that will get to the Abba market. And he rode, and he got to Jibowu roundabout. Just to enter, he has gotten to Jibowu, heading towards the Abba. And Elijah was still here. He had his car. He had his horse. He has gotten to Jibowu bus stop, heading towards the Abba market. And verse 46, and the hand of the Lord was on Elijah when Ahab has gotten to Jibowu. The hand of the Lord was on Elijah, and he gathered up his horse and ran. Past tense of run is what? Ran. And he began to run with his legs from here to the same Yaba market, and ran before Ahab to the entrance of Jezreel. Because of what? The hand of God was on him. The one that used cow that had gotten to Jibowu was still there driving. The one that was running, now he was there. He began to run now, and he was driving. He passed him. It was nothing but supernatural speed and the finger of God. Because God said his hand was on him in 2017. Those who are ahead of you, who refuse to open door for you to enter, God will clear them for you to enter. Those who are ahead of you, who have refused to open the door for you to enter, in 2017, God will clear them for you to enter. Listen to me. Everybody, lay a hand on your head, because you are receiving the hand of God now. In that name that is above your name, receive the hand of God to function in 2017. Receive the hand of God to function in 2017. If you are, shout out amen very loud. Settled.